It's Monday morning and it's 3 a.m. I am just heading off to Gatwick to go out to Amsterdam. Do my absolute best to keep everybody in my little development asleep.
When you've got a good network around you, it just doesn't really feel like things can go wrong.
What a nightmare.
What am I doing?
Yeah, look at this, I'm in a brand new car. So it's still Monday, and we have made it over to In-Lite. Very cool showroom, and a lot of their products have been really well displayed. So yeah, I think the UK suppliers can definitely take a leaf out of this book. Yeah, it looks great. Very impressed. Meanwhile, back at home, Monday morning, so another van breakdown. Jake's maintenance van won't start this morning. Electrical battery issues, so that's off to the garage, hopefully be sorted fairly swiftly. Just found out that we've been shortlisted for a Pro Landscaper award, which is very exciting. So yeah, cheers to the Pro Landscaper guys and girls. Fingers crossed.
So, let's do a toast.
Cheers, Tash. Cheers. Great day. Cheers. Really appreciate it.
Cheers.
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 Cheers. Well.
Cheers.
It's Tuesday morning. Pretty uninspiring weather here in the Netherlands. We are off to another supplier factory tour today, which we're looking forward to. And over in East Horsley, the pergola steels are being delivered.
Who are you, Major?
Yes, please.
Good morning. How are you doing?
Good. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good, thank you. It's an exciting morning because the steels are going in today for the pergola. So obviously got the four legs up now. These I-beams, the narrower ones go between, and then the long one goes along the front, and then I think these big chunky ones are to house the skylight in the middle. So yeah, so it was spec'd originally to be timber, but obviously sought advice from a structural engineer, and because it's housing glass, any sort of movement would potentially be a little bit dangerous, so
sure.
The advice from the structural engineer was go steel.
It's Wednesday morning and I'm back to the beautiful March weather, but it is lovely to be back. The last few days, so from the Eden project last week through to In-Lite in Shelovis with Landscape Plus out in Amsterdam, I mean, yeah, what a whirlwind. It's been amazing to meet so many other really great sort of young business owners in the same sector as well, and do some, you know, really great networking. Pretty tired, don't really know what sort of day it is or where I am, but yeah, feeling very inspired. When you've got a good network around you, it just doesn't really feel like things can go wrong. Yeah, really value all of those guys and all of their time, and you know, especially Paul from Landscape Plus for organizing everything. It was it was amazing. So I'm just out with the dogs at the moment. I'm hanging around this morning until 9:30, which is in another half an hour, because then I'm signing the finance docs for my new vehicle. They are coming over to see me for a signature all the way from Manchester, which is absolutely insane, but there you go. Luckily I don't do that for a living. What else? While I've been gone and, you know, have been so flat out, I haven't really been massively in touch with what's going on, but East Horsley's been running really well. Chiswick has been running really well. Jake's been busy on the maintenance. He had a bit of a hiccup with his van, but otherwise everyone's just been cracking on as normal. I've had a bit of a cash flow pinch while I was out, which was a pain, but Jake's been finishing jobs, AD's been invoicing them, so we're starting to see this little self-sufficient creation coming to life, which is, yeah, such an amazing feeling. Back in the office, I have signed my finance docs, I have gone to the yard and moved all the van or the cars and vans and trucks that are being picked up today around, taken the hitch locks off the trailers. So yeah, all ready to go for this afternoon when everything starts moving. Back at my desk now, just playing catch up. Yeah, just clearing quick to-dos so I can then focus back on the long to-dos. So Harry, who we spoke about, who has joined us again very excitingly, he's been working up in London, but having a catch up with him this evening, which I'm looking forward to, so it'd be good to find out how he's sort of settling in. Bought another DJI. All of this is filmed on a DJI, so essentially it looks like one of these. This is the newer version, so Harry's going to have the second version. This is the third version, which I'll then move into. I'm told it's better. All I know is that it was 650 quid. So yeah, it better get me to 1,000 subscribers pretty quickly.
Morning people, Harry here. Good progress over in Chiswick so far. Lots have gone on here. We have dug out all by hand, carried through the house, smashing it out, myself, Andy, and Mark from Botanicals. Amazing progress.
It's Thursday. What have I done? What am I doing? Taking the dog for a quick run before I have to go for the third of our vehicles this week to be picked up. We've got lots of space again to actually start moving into our new yard. The internal fit out company are there today carrying on the concrete panelling. So yeah, more good progress. What else have I done today? Just had a really good Zoom call with one of the directors from Fowler Pools. They're a really fantastic, sort of very well established high-end swimming pool company based pretty locally to us. So their projects are all within our sort of catchment area, and they work with a lot of the sort of higher end designers that we also work with. So he's sending over a couple of projects for us to look at implementing for them. So to do all the surrounding landscapes. So yeah, that's great, a great opportunity. He's watched our YouTube videos, really likes them. Everyone always knows what I'm doing and what I've done. So that's it, that's interesting. It still feels a little bit weird. I went over to our sign writers this morning. Our new vans that are coming, we had the sign writing proofs for, but wanting to tweak a few things. So I went in there this morning and got those things tweaked. So yeah, really happy with what we've come up with. The single cab tippers don't give you loads of space for being creative with sign writing. So I think what we've achieved is great compromise and looks a lot more exciting to me than sort of the original ideas. So tomorrow I'm picking up my new van. I will call it a van because technically it is a van. To HMRC it is a van. What else? Interviewed our own in-house designer last night, so I've had a few good follow-up conversations with her today. We'll see where it goes. It's a dynamic that needs to obviously be very carefully considered from both sides. Over in East Horsley, the steel frame for the pergola was finished, so that's great. The skylight framing is now in, which is the internal frame within the frame. The guys are doing a great job at getting all of the base materials in for the new paths, and Matt has gone to see a new project. It's been a frustrating few weeks. 2024 has been tough, but it's going to be pretty amazing seeing a line of 24 plate vans in our yard. I'm sure that's going to be a bit of a humbling sort of pinch myself moment, so yeah, I'm looking forward to getting them. But yeah, it's been good. We're in sort of as good a place as we can be. Yeah, I'm picking up my new puppy on Saturday, so it's going to be a weekend without work just to sort of really get to know him and hang out with him, and yeah, really looking forward to that. Jess is away, so it's just me and the dogs at home, so yeah, it's going to be lovely. Not because Jess is away, of course, because there's a new puppy coming. First video on the new DJI. Very fancy. I'm at the yards. It is still Thursday afternoon, and look what is still here. So we sold this on motorway. Actually almost pretty embarrassed to admit that I accepted an offer of £13,000 on it. That is cheap, but you know, we just needed the cash in the bank, help with the new vehicles, get it done. You know, it needs a bit of tidying up. They sent down somebody to come pick it up. The person picked it up about half an hour later. Got an email from the dealership just saying that they've decided to remove £3,000 from their offer because the tyre pressure warning light was on. All that needed is some air in the tyres. The sensors are all fine, so just told them put some tyre put some air in the tyres and that's fine. And then they also complained that there was no locking wheel nuts. Well, as I explained when they bought it, very boringly, I don't know if you can see that, it doesn't need a locking wheel nut. There is no locking wheel nut on these wheels, so why the hell I would supply one, I don't know. And how on earth a bit of air from a pump at a petrol station or a compressor and a made up issue was worth $3,000. So that was a very unfriendly conversation. And yeah, I was pretty angry, to be honest. I had to call the guy who'd picked it up and tell him to come and bring it back because we weren't going to accept the offer. And yeah, now I've got to sell it again. What a nightmare. And yeah, because of that, because of having to then wait for him to come back, I had to cancel a meeting. I'm freezing. I haven't been on my run. Yes, it doesn't look it because this camera's amazing. Wow. But it is now 22:06. It's getting dark. So yeah, I'm gonna have to go home, feed the dogs, sort myself out, and get a really early night and go for a big run tomorrow before we have a more positive day. Yeah, testing. Another day in the life, learning the hard way. Oof. I like that grey, looks smart. Collection day, yeah, it feels good. Yeah, hopefully it actually starts. We had a phone call on the way saying that they couldn't actually get it started, which I'm struggling with the, trying to be all smiley on camera. No, I'm very excited to be picking it up. But yeah, it turns out the company that fitted the tracker had left the immobiliser on do not start mode. So we had to get that taken off, but yeah, luckily it is now starting. We've been assured.
You've got the additional 1 year warranty.
Mm-hmm.
And you've got the smart guard, which is your paint and scratch protection, and
perfect.
There was no Gardex.
Cool.
You can just sign in that little block there for me. Cheers.
Wow, really do have the whole thing placed to ourselves.
There we go. Well, Ollie, congrats on your new car, mate.
Thank you very much.
There is your key box.
Thank you.
And inside is there's two sets of key rings.
Perfect.
And two keys. I've got the one here.
Oof. So it's not a Defender. Nice habit, it's nice that it starts. It's yeah, looking forward to putting some miles on it. What a lovely place to be, what a lovely place to sit. Can't really believe it. Yeah, look at this, I'm in a brand new car. 24 plate, yeah, well not for long, we've got a personalised plate for it, but yeah, 24 plate. Nice mate, so yeah, gonna head straight back to it, gonna head over to East Horsley now, check on the guys, check on the site, see how everyone's getting on. Cool. Obviously biggest progress is the absolutely ginormous pergola frame. So all galvanized steel. It's all in onto huge concrete pads, something about a meter and a half by a meter and a half for each leg. They've gone into the house onto pad stones. So yeah, it is never going anywhere. And as with everything, as soon as a structural engineer is involved, it is pretty seriously over-engineered. But yeah. It's big. Obviously everything's been really leveled out and cleared as well, which is great to see. So you can actually start to see the shape of the design. The guys are just putting in the metal edging, which is the border to the path that we're doing. And you can see there's some Teram membrane and Type 1 MOT over it as well. So that's gonna form the base. which will go underneath all the gravel, which goes on top. It's all nice Cotswold chippings. Hedging is obviously in as far as we can go. So next week, the plan as well is to get the bigger digger off and out of there. We've also got our last grab lorry coming, so then we can close that bit back off and get the last of the hedges planted in front of it. But yeah, next week, this is all going to be re-rendered, so re-skimmed, so you can see where we've cut in, where we've taken the old pergola down and then cut in for the new pergola. That's all going to be covered up. But to avoid any sort of visible patching, the clients have just gone for re-skimming the whole rear flank of the house, which, yes, is obviously a bit of an extra cost, but I think we're worth it, and they agree. So East Horsley is going well. The sun's shining. You can see how much it's dried out as well, which is the main thing. The weather was starting to become a bit of a problem here. Yeah, it's all starting to come together. So decking frame's pretty much there as well. We needed a few more joists, so we've ordered them from London Stone, and they're actually apparently being delivered this afternoon. So they'll be here ready for next week as well. Oh, we've also got a big new sort of shed bike workshop being built. That's going in next week as well. So ticking off the list with a bit of momentum now. So fingers crossed, the sky looks like this and we can actually make some more good progress.
Quote of the day?
Oh, cut it, I've got a good one.
Dan, what was my quote from yesterday?
Yeah.
There's no bad news if good news follows. There you go.
Hello, people.